Hello and welcome. Today we're going to talk about how to install the Ring contact sensor. This is a window and door sensor. It's a Z-Wave model. We're going to tell you how to get that hooked up with your SmartThings app. That's up next. All right, let's go ahead and see what's in the package. So opening up, very nice package here. It's well packaged. It has instructions on how to get started. It even has a little QR code on the device. You'll see here in a second. Let's put this packaging to the side. We'll remove this sleeve. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and try to pair this. Before I remove the tab, I wanna show you what's under the hood. So let's go ahead and look at that. It comes with two CR2032 nickel cell batteries, so that's pretty nice. It should give you a pretty long lasting device before you have to replace those batteries. So before we tear off the tab to start pairing, let's go ahead and add this device. So I'm going to hit the plus sign at the top. We're going to select devices, and I'm going to, per the instructions that I received on the SmartThings community app, I'm going to go ahead and scan the QR code to add this. The QR code, as you see, is located right there at the top. This, by the way, is a Z-Wave S2, as indicated there. So let's go ahead and see if we can find that QR code here. All right, so that is scanned. It says getting everything ready. Let's hit start. And I'm going to put this in our family room. And we'll hit done. And next. Okay, so it's preparing. So we'll go ahead. It says get your device ready to connect. And so what we need to do at this point is go ahead and pull the tab, which will start discovery. And per the instructions on the SmartThings community website, it says to hold this button down for 10 seconds. So let's go ahead and pull the tab. So it appears to be in discovery mode. It is flashing there green. So let's go ahead and hold that down for 10 seconds. 1004, 1005, 1006, 1007, 1008, 1009, 1010. All right, we'll go ahead and release that. And it does take a good 30 seconds to a minute to find this device, I find. As a matter of fact, I tried this before making this video and I had to attempt a couple of times to get it to pair. So I think you just need to be patient to see if it'll find it. Wait at least 30 seconds to see if it's discovered. If it's not, then try to hit the button again. By the way, it's flashing green. I'm not sure if the camera's picking that up, but it's flashing green continuously. That means it is in pairing mode. When it is ready, oh, it looks like it's found it. It says preparing. Okay, it did find it. So it just takes almost a minute to connect, so you just have to be patient. So we'll hit done. I'll rename this at a later point. All right, there you see it there in the device, indicating ready. Now, here's what I want to show you. When you open this up, you're going to be disappointed because you're going to see that it shows the battery. It doesn't show that it's either open or closed. So very limited functionality here. But all we need to do is go into sign into your SmartThings account, and then you need to find the device, which in here it's indicated as Z-Wave sensor. And we just need to change the device type in there. And then you'll see that it has the functions of open and close, and it will also show you the level of the battery as well. So let's go ahead into my SmartThings account and I'll show you how to get that set up. Okay, so let's go ahead and go into the SmartThings account. That's account.smartthings.com. I'm gonna go ahead and sign in. And then you wanna go to My Devices, as you see up here. Click on My Devices. And you're basically going to be looking for that device that you just added, which is a Z-Wave sensor. So that should be at the bottom of your list. Since this is alphabetical, you'll see that it's The device type is listed as Z-Wave Sensor. We want to change that. So let's click on Z-Wave Sensor. Scroll down, hit Edit. All right, when you're in this screen, the only thing we really need to change is the type here. So you're changing the device type handler. So select the drop-down list. And in this list, we're looking for Z-Wave plus door window sensor. So this is the correct type here. Select that, hit Update. And we should be good to go. Go back to your devices, make sure that's a change is accepted. Takes a while to refresh here. And scroll down. And you see now the device type is Z-Wave plus door window sensor. That's all there is to it. Let's go back to the SmartThings app and look at our device and see what it looks like at this point. All right, I'm showing that my device is showing up as a contact sensor now that we have it set up in the SmartThings account. First thing you really want to do is go ahead and close your app completely. Then go back in. This sort of refreshes everything and make sure that everything's set up. You give it a second to make sure everything is updated. All right, let's go into My Devices now. And you can see the Z-Wave sensor showing open at the bottom of the screen there. Let's go ahead and close it. So it's showing it's closed. Let's go ahead and open it back up. It's open. It's a little delayed in the response. When I open it back up, I not experienced that the first time I tested it, but now it's open, closed. Oh, maybe I wasn't far enough away. So it looks like it's got a pretty good range, which is good. So let's open, there we go. It's very responsive that way. So you have to remove this considerable distance away. It looks like about 4 inches. When does it connect? Looks like in that area there, about inch. And when we take it away greater than an inch, it shows open. So let's see how responsive. Closed and open. Closed and open. So very responsive. Let's look at the information we have. So it shows the battery at 100%, shows the contact sensor open. Let's close it. There's closed position and open. So everything's set up, working properly. Really nice looking sensor. And seems to be extremely responsive, and once you get the correct device type handler on it, it works very well. By the way, I have in my Amazon store a number of contact sensors that are compatible with the SmartThings app, as well as motion sensors and a variety of other sensors as well. I indicate how to get them set up, whether they're connected out of the box, or if you need to change a device type handler like we did here. And in some cases, you have to install a custom device type handler. Now, I have video instructions on many devices on how to set up custom device handlers, and it's not as difficult as you think. Just want to take the opportunity to thank you for watching today. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you found this video helpful. We'll see you next time, and God bless.